David here from Fig Boot on Pens. Today I'm going to be taking a look at a brand new fountain pen which was recently released by the retailer Jet Pens. And that pen is the Jet Pens Mini Aluminum. I'm going to go over the parts and the features of the Mini Aluminum, talk about some of the things I care for and some of the things I don't care for, show some measurements, some size comparisons, and then provide a writing sample. Jet Pens was kind enough to send along a couple of their Mini Aluminum pens for review purposes, and no other compensation was provided, but I will be giving away one of these pens, so stay tuned to find out how to enter to win. The Mini Aluminum is a joint venture between Jet Pens and a pen company called Regal, which is a company that's been around since 1979 and I believe is based out of the Portland, Oregon area. This is the first Regal pen that I've had a chance to check out. The Mini Aluminum is an entry-level pen, and this is how it arrives. No box, just this plastic sleeve, and inside we have the pen. This is the pearl white finish. It also comes in a glossy black, which I have one here. This is the glossy black, and then also a satin gold finish. I don't have that one, but we'll look at the white one. I think it shows up a little bit better on camera. As you can see, it's a very small pen. It's the ideal size for like a pocketbook or a purse or even a portfolio that doesn't accommodate a larger pen. So let's start with the cap. You can see here that the end is rounded with a small flattish part on top. And then we have the clip, which extends for almost the entire length of the cap. And it has a pinched section right here when you look at it sideways, it kind of gives the appearance of an elongated arrowhead. And it has a decent amount of spring to it. And it feels fairly solid. On the end of the cap down here, it's branded with the Jet Pens name. On the black version, the lettering is in white. And on the gold and this white version, the lettering is black. Then we have a silver colored band, which is actually part of the section. And then a smooth transition to the barrel, which tapers down slightly and is rounded at the end. And the barrel end is fully rounded. And then, as the name suggests, the Mini Aluminum is made out of lacquered aluminum. The cap snaps off. And it has a rather nice snapping mechanism. You know, it feels secure and it doesn't take an inordinate amount of effort to operate. So here we have the rather smallish nib. It's a steel nib. I'm not sure the physical size of the nib, but it's very close to that size of the nib that's on the Kaweco Sport. And here's a picture of the feed. I haven't tried to remove the nib to see if you could replace it. On their site, Jet Pens says that it's a non-replaceable nib, so I'll take their word for it rather than causing some undue damage to this pen. Now, currently the Mini Aluminum is only offered in an extra fine nib, and Jet Pens has said that other nib sizes are a possibility down the line, but not for a while. You know, the section is a bit on the small side, as you can imagine, for a small pen, but it's usable. There is a step-up transition to the barrel, which isn't sharp at all, which is good because with the short section, you're typically having to kind of grip it on that transition as you're holding it, unless you have very small or thin fingers. You know, the barrel is very short. In order for me to use it comfortably, I do need to have it posted. It will post securely, but you really kind of have to get it on there with a little bit of force. If you post it half-heartedly, then the cap has a tendency, at least on the two that I have, to get a little loose when you're writing and it rubs against your hand. So you just need to make sure that you get it on there. But when it's capped, it does have a decent length. And for a small pen, the aluminum gives it a decent weight. So it while it's a little bit light, it does have a little bit of substance to it. This is a cartridge converter pen, and it does come with a black international short ink cartridge, but it does not come with a converter. A standard international converter is too long for this pen. It doesn't fit inside the barrel. What I have found works are the Kaweco squeeze converters, which I have in there right now. And I haven't tested them, but the Kaweco Mini or the Monteverde Mini converters will possibly work with this as well. I'm not quite sure, but I think they will. The Mini Aluminum retails for $12.50. And so, like I said, it's an entry-level pen. And it's only available through JetPen's website. And I'll provide a link to the product page on the notes below. We'll talk about how it performs in the writing sample, but for the price, this is a decent little pen. If you like small pens, then you might want to check this one out. You know, I wish they were offered in more nib choices. You know, I typically prefer mediums, but you know, if you're the same, it might take a little bit to get used to the extra fine nib. Though, I do find that having an extra fine nib is useful on this particular pen, because chances are you're going to be carrying this around with you. You're going to be signing a receipt or jotting something down on a post-it note or writing a check or something along those lines. And while I love a big, fat, juicy nib, in situations like those, most of the times a heavy ink flow is not practical. You know, I ruined a check the other day because I signed it with a nice pen and I accidentally smeared it, and so I had to do it all over again. And so having a pen like this that is a bit on the dry side and extra fine that performs fairly well could be useful in those situations. You know, this isn't a big fancy pen. It's a $12 pocket pen, but it's not pretending to be something that it's not. And for what it is, it's pretty decent. The most obvious comparison is to the Pilot Metropolitan. In that regard, the Metro is a little bit larger. We'll see in the size comparisons. But, you know, in that regard, I have to say I prefer the Metro a little bit more, mainly because it's a bit larger. But the Mini Aluminum is decent in its own right. As I mentioned earlier, JetPens was kind enough to send along a Mini Aluminum for me to give away. If you would care to win one of these pens, it'd be nice if you're a subscriber to my channel. That's not a requirement, but that would be nice. If you're not already, hit the subscribe button and then just leave a comment here on YouTube. You know, maybe let me know what your favorite small pen is. You don't have to answer that question, but it's just a suggestion for a topic to make it a little more interesting than just leaving a generic comment. Today is Saturday, July 23rd, 2016, and sometime after midnight on Wednesday, July 27th, I'll randomly select a comment, and then that person will win this pen. And actually, you could have your choice between the white or the black one. You know what? Actually, the DC Pen Show is in 2 weeks, and just so you know that I'll be up there for the majority of the weekend. If you happen to be there and see me walking around, make sure to say hi. I'd love to meet some of you folks. And, you know, the pen shows are social gatherings as well. So now let's take a look at some measurements, some size comparisons, and then a writing sample. So here we go with some size comparisons for the JetPens Mini Aluminum. Here it is with a Kaweco Sport. You can see that the Sport's actually smaller. Then here it is with the Pilot Metropolitan, and the Pilot Metro is significantly larger than this pen. And then here it is with a Pelican M200. And then here it is with a Pilot Stella 90S. And it's actually just about the same length as a Stella 90S. And then in regard to some much larger pens, here it is with a Pelican M1000, then a Visconti Homo Sapiens, and then here it is with a Montblanc 149. So, on to the writing sample. We have the JetPens Mini Aluminum and this is an extra fine steel nib, and the ink that we're using today is Iroshizuku Amarillo or Amaero, excuse me. This is what the ink looks like. that I'm a big fan of the Iroshizuku inks. This is Konpeki, so you can see how it compares to that. It's just a little bit lighter than Konpeki. Konpeki still has a little bit more sheen to it, but there is on the heavier areas a bit of sheen on this one as well. Somewhere similar in color to the Bookbinder's Blue Coral ink, which I'll probably look at a little bit more in another review, but it's somewhat similar to that. And you know, these are the bottles for the Iroshizuku inks. They're some of my favorite bottles out there. I really like the little reservoir here at the bottom. Not only does it serve a purpose to let you get the nib down a little bit further, but I think it just style-wise looks very, very cool. So here we go with the rest of the writing sample. For an extra fine nib, I think it does a good job. It's not overly scratchy. You're not going to get a lot of line variation out of an extra fine steel nib. That even with a little bit of pressure, I don't want to push it too much, but you're not going to get a ton of variation. And in regard to wetness, this is, as I mentioned before, fairly dry pen. And in regard to reverse writing, it can be done, and it's not too bad. And in regard to fast writing, it does just fine, and the feed keeps up very nice. So wanted to give thanks to JetPens.com. Thanks for providing these pens for review and for giveaway. We have here the JetPens Mini Aluminum. There it is in the pearl white, and here it is in the satin black, or the glossy black, excuse me. If you'd like to check out additional details about this pen, just click the link in the notes below, and it will take you right to the information on their website. And I appreciate them providing these pens for review and giveaway. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you later.